A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 1st June, on the front page you have Amit Shah gets home in new cabinet. So new cabinet has been formed and the various ministers are detailed out here. You can see Amit Shah has become the home minister, Rajnath Singh has become the defense minister, Nirmala Sitharaman is the new finance minister, and so on. Then this is GDP growth slumps to 5.8%, unemployment rate at 45-year high. So this is the GDP growth going down and unemployment rate increasing, detailed out here, the statistics. And this is India lifts curbs on airspace. So India has lifted curbs on airspace for Pakistan. So this will be a relief to thousands of air travelers affected due to the closure of Pakistan airspace. So now the ball is in Pakistan's court. Pakistan also has to lift the curbs which it has put on India over its airspace. And this is below normal rainfall, likely northwest, northeast. So this is Indian Meteorological Department. It says that there will be below normal rainfall in these two regions, but normal monsoon is expected over the rest of India. Then on page 7 you have Supreme Court asks Maharashtra to revise postgraduate medical course merit list sans EWS quota, economically weaker sections quota. So Supreme Court has pulled up Maharashtra government for overreaching the order against implementation of this 10% reservation for economically weaker sections. So this has been announced recently, but the Supreme Court, when it was questioned in the Supreme Court said that it should not be applicable from the present academic year 2019-20. Still, the Maharashtra government provided 10% reservation for the present academic year for 225 students. So now the Supreme Court has pulled up the government and has asked it to come up with a revised merit list for admissions and complete the counseling by 4th June. Means the admission process of counseling. On page 9 you have Admiral Karambir Singh takes over as Navy Chief. So Admiral Karambir Singh has assumed office as the 24th Chief of the Naval Staff, taking over from Admiral Sunil Lamba, who stepped down post retirement. So upon retirement. So this is it. And then you should know about Vice Admiral Bimal Verma also, who has approached the Armed Forces Tribunal questioning the appointment of the Army Chief, as he was the most senior naval officer after Admiral Lamba, but he was superseded. And below you have NGT wrapped states for not curbing pollution in Ganga. So National Green Tribunal has wrapped states Bengal, Bihar, Jharkhand, and they have been fined rupees 25 lakh each for not curbing pollution in River Ganga. On the editorial page, the first editorial is his new council. So this is regarding the new council of ministers for the second Modi government. So it says there is clear realignment of power in the second Modi government. And this is the second election. So this is regarding Israel, how it goes back to voters within 6 months to have a new mandate. So how Israel's political landscape is changing is detailed out here. The lead article, the idea of Congress free India. So this is the article which talks about Congress, which has been the biggest hurdle to those devoted to remaking India into a Hindu Rashtra or into a socialist utopia. So this is an article on that. It's political, you can skip it too. Then this is outlining the first 100 days. So this article talks of how the first 100 days of the new government should be. It says there must be a revamp of how government services are delivered and how India does business. And on Saturdays on the OPET page, you have a ground zero coverage. So presently it's about Raichur in northern Karnataka, which is under a grip of severe water shortage. So it says a thirsty land between two rivers. The struggle of the people in the region is detailed out here. Here you can see it's Krishna and Tungabhadra River between which Raichur lies, and it is water starved presently. On page 12 you have US reiterates threat of sanctions over Trump deal. So acquisition of missile, Trump missile from Russia, you know, so USA has again threatened sanctions over this. So it had come up with this act, you know, CATSA. So the CATSA is actually for countering America's adversaries through sanctions act. So if any country has defense deals with Russia, significant defense deals, then it will be sanctioned. So this is the CATSA act under which India's purchase of Trump missile system from Russia is being, you know, resisted or opposed by USA. And this is India to lose preferential trade terms with US. So this is regarding GSP, Generalized System of Preferences benefits, which is given to developing countries by developed nations. So USA also provides these benefits, and India is the largest beneficiary of this. But recently we have seen how US president has been up in arms against trade surpluses which various countries have with USA, and India also has a trade surplus with USA. So now USA wants to withdraw the GSP benefits which India gets, and it says this is imminent, this is going to take place. So India is putting in efforts to ensure that GSP program continues for India. On page 13 you have this coverage on the Council of Ministers, and below you have double spend on education, says NEP draft. So this is National Education Policy draft. So it talks of doubling the percentage of public expenditure on education, also setting up of an overreaching National Education Commission as well as National Research Foundation. So encouraging primary school education in mother tongue and incorporating traditional Indian knowledge systems into the curriculum are the key recommendations under the draft National Education Policy released recently. On international page, you have North Korea executed envoy after failed Hanoi summit. So this is South Korean paper which says that North Korean leader Kim Jong-un's interpreter has been sent to prison camp after the Hanoi summit between US President Donald Trump and North Korean leader Kim Jong-un failed. And this is US to hit Mexico with tariffs over migration. So this is regarding how USA has now initiated first set of fines which will be imposed in June on Mexico because of migration issue. And this is use Huawei and lose access to our data. So this is what USA has warned to Germany. It says it will cut intelligence sharing with Germany if it continues to have Huawei, you know, the Chinese telecom major company having relations with Germany. So many countries have banned it, and Germany has also been asked to take action else lose access to intelligence sharing from USA. And this is won't give up search for Budapest victims. So this is South Korea which has vowed not to give up hope in the search for 21 people still missing 2 days after the sightseeing boat carrying mainly South Korean tourists sank on the Danube River in Europe. So this accident which took place in Budapest, Hungary, in which South Korean nationals are mainly involved. So this is a statement coming here. Then on business page you have tight-fisted center meets deficit target. So fiscal deficit for the present financial year ended financial year came at 3.39% as against a 3.4% projected in the revised estimates of the budget. So government has been able to meet the fiscal deficit target. On page 16 you have Google to curb third-party access. So it will tighten norms for accessing user data for Chrome extensions, Google Drive. So there are growing global concerns over data privacy and security. This has made Google announce that it will further tighten guidelines for third-party developers for accessing user data for Chrome extensions and Google Drive. On the last page you have Philippines returns trash to Canada. So tons of garbage has been sent, which had been sent to Philippines years ago, has been shipped back to Canada after festering diplomatic row. So this is 69 shipping containers of garbage have been loaded onto a cargo vessel to begin its trip to Canada now. And this is e-cigarettes pose public health risk, says Indian Council of Medical Research. It dismisses claims that the device can help cut tobacco use. So e-cigarettes have been controversial, and ICMR has given its say that they are a public health risk and are not going to help cut tobacco use. And this is time to start studying females too. So in experiments on animals, the default practice is to examine males because they are less complex. But now it is said that US neurobiologists, you know, is also saying that now it's time to start studying females too. And this is Japan unveils policy to curb plastic waste. So Japan plans to press for a deal at G20 summit too to reduce plastic dumping into the ocean. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com. Thank you.